Hello, so this is Harlan. This has been in early access for such a long time, but now it's finally released and you can enjoy it. This is more like Outward, so you don't know what you're doing, you have no idea where to go or what is good or what is bad, and this is basically the prologue. You start as a little fox, and yeah, it's the same as Outward in the way that you have to progress through the game, you have quests, you have items, but it has, you know, a unique twist to it. Such a cute little foxy. Listen well. Come, open me in the well. Yeah, so this is all, you know, something imaginary or something surreal. And this is more like a light adventure, light fantasy game, but with a lot of, you know, interesting stuff happening. Oh, look at the boars, they are so cute. They don't even look menacing, right? Okay, let's skip this first part because you can explore a lot here, by the way. You can knock down the bottles. Physics. And this game has a lot of details in it. Just look at how nice the sheep are looking today. Okay, let's follow that man. That man may be us. Yeah, you'll get stuck in the fence. Don't worry, you can manage. And I think this is the place... Okay, that was us or something like that. This is the place where you start your journey off. Yeah, let's knock down stuff. Let's be a troublemaker. Ah, that's some delicious fish over there. Again, I'm just doing this because I want to show you the art style of the game. And if you like the art style, you will definitely appreciate the game and play it. And you know, for what it is, the game gives you a lot of freedom. Ceres, Capra, Cobol, Marprax. Yeah, this is some weird stuff. But again, the game lets you explore and come here in case you want to check out everything you can do. But you're basically not even given a quest in this game. You just have to go into that direction, find something out and, you know, hope for the best. I have no idea what these guys are doing here, but it's very, very suspicious. And that's a big, big helmet over there. Yeah, so it looks like they're having a funeral or something to remember their warriors by. I'm fairly sure if you go into the water, you'll die sooner or later. But again, just to show you that the developers really went out of their way to put this area into the game, even though it's not really needed. So yeah, not a lot of dialogue, not a lot of things are told, you are not being held by your hand. And the funny part is that you don't even play as the fox. This is just a little chapter in your long road. Man on the deck. Where are we sailing? Somewhere else. The piece is the only head. Okay, so let's set sail. And here you can see you have beds and you have a lot of things which look really weird. Especially the fruit barrels and the vegetables out on the deck like this, and the bottles. But this is the priceless relic. Okay then, let's finish it, because you can explore a lot and, you know, waste time, but wake him up. Hello, your pet fox has arrived. I have an interesting message. And now everything starts falling apart. Again, this is the slow part of the game. As you can see, everything is getting flooded. And sadly, there's nothing you can do to skip this part. Look at him, he's floating in the air and he has a little pistol. He's watching me, that's very creepy. But as you can see, the lights are over here, the candles, they will eventually be underwater. So let's swim and get to a high place. I don't know, I could tell you a lot about Harlan. This game has a lot of unique things and, you know, it actually features a combat system that's not so good but not so bad. And you also have to find a lot of items that you'll get to keep. So if you die, don't worry, you can just respawn and go back and challenge those enemies. Help me? As you can see, the water is also swallowing the sails. Oh, I fell overboard. And this is the really dramatic part. As you can see, this ship was huge. And that's a castle in the distance. And that's the flag going down. And those are just vegetables and orpel. Sadly, we can't skip this, so we'll just have to wait about 5 more minutes until we get to the real gameplay. Come on, wake up. Wake up, Jackie. What game was that? Yeah, so this game has been in development for my squeaky chair. For, I don't know, 4 years? 3 years? I have no idea, I can't remember. But now it's actually worth it to play it because, you know, it's a unique adventure and besides, it's so cute and fluffy and adorable. I don't know, maybe I'll post again. Don't worry, the game didn't crash. This is normal. Move to stand up. Hello, little piggy. Oh, you're such a cute piggy. Hey, you want a drink? Either you can pick up the barrels and throw them. Well, at least some of them. Hey, you want a barrel? Don't worry, he won't be harmed. And this is the king's head, you'll need it. That's our old bed. What happened? The ship from Samarkand crashed, that's... when you are carrying a holy relic. Sleeping can save your progress in your life. Actually, I'm superstitious about this head. But holy relics always return to Harla, no matter what, I see. And who are you? They sent me here to meet the ship. Who sent you? Uruthal, okay. Oh, and that's her pet pig, I think, Mildred. Anyway, that's funny. And this is the ship we crashed in. As you can see, you can do a lot of things. Even some Skyrim walking. But now the game is actually very unique in that it doesn't really tell you much. So we just have to figure things out for ourselves. Okay, so this is the inventory, the most important thing. A key, a small key. Unlicensed locks to be destroyed, one time use only. 5 other pieces make me whole, we'll hunt together. I like to, you know, be strong. And this is the map, and this is everything you're shown. The rest is up to you, by the way, you can drone, I think, and die. Take a little shower in the morning. Or a little swim. And from now on, it's all open world. Well, almost open world, but believe me, this is more open world than Gridfall. And some of the other games that I played. You can take his cheese and speak with him, by the way. Okay, let's speak with him. I'm not here to be alone. Especially if you eat right after bed. What do you eat before bed? Four pints, okay, that's funny. Yes, we have to give him 4 pints all, Beltanianel. This is your first quest. And if you forget the quest, well, tough luck. You can only zoom on the map. And it will show you the things you can get. And now we have unlocked that fire camp. By By the way, you can pick up some armor and some shields again, but it's not really optional how to put it. You can miss them if you're not careful. And now let me see, where was that sword? Oh yeah, here it is, steel sword. This is the merchant. Well, he's a bit dead at the moment, so he can't really talk back to you. And that's Heartland Brew, a compass, a drowned heart, and a lockpick. As you can see, they all go in their own slots, so yeah. Let's put the shield over there. That increases your armor, 170, plus this one. This is a level 4 sword, so we can't really use it. But we can eat the heart. As you can see, they are very expensive because they will give you a lot of experience. We're a bit wounded at the moment, but don't worry, we'll be fine. Now let's explore some more again. I will try to make the episode shorter, but sometimes the game is just too fun to play. And don't worry, I don't remember anything from what I played before, so yeah. But and also got this key for free from the developer, which is really, I don't know, it makes my day happier because, you know, getting a free key from someone, it's always a nice thing. Especially because I've been working so hard on the channel sometimes. And after Gridfall, I don't know, I was just a bit upset and I had to build my PC. And look at this big guy. His head is huge. Also has a big axe. Okay, let's speak with this man. Yes, I did. What happened here? Who's Lomi? Which is why he's a drunk. He couldn't afford his unions. Okay, I'll skip most of the dialogue because, you know, it's not so important. Who killed the knight? An ambush. An elder guardian was so far from the root hall. I don't see any imp. And you can also pick up this hat. By the way, as you can see, it's sometimes it looks like it's getting brighter outside. That's because there is night and day. You can actually use those. Requires level 2, but this one is level 1 and it's 100, and again, this is how the game is designed. And everything you equip actually shows on your character. This is you. Let's explore a bit more, because as I said, exploration is really encouraged and, you know, who knows what you could find. And you can also find a lot more hearts. But first, let's explore this little area. And as you can see, it's weird in the beginning, but the more you play, the more sense it will make. By the way, we have stamina, so we can't run forever like this. Well, this is weird. Okay, we should not be here. Eh, more or less, we should be here, but not now. This is getting very, very weird and dark. Yeah, but before you come here, you just have to sleep. So let's go outside to Barry's field again. What was that, a wooden stick? Oh, and that's a sheep. Okay, so let's go back and I'll show you some of the other things you can do. Let's speak with this guy first. Eagle lens, what? Merchant Union. Yes, of course. And that's a lock door. You can unlock it with the lockpick. But I'm not really sure you want to do that right now. And he's a licensed merchant. I think this is all cosmetic, by the way. Medium purse. Also some keys, some vegetables, again, a lot of healing items. This is the one thing I want. 160? Why? Ah, let's sell the small elixir. And then let's buy the shovel, because that's an item we really use. And now let's find the graveyards, because, you know, shovel, graveyards, money. You get the general idea. And this is a tender heart. Delicious. So let's take a little nap, because this will save your progress, and then you'll also see a little cutscene with something very weird. You dream, and you will dream deeper. Sadly, you can't skip all of this. You'll just have to waste a few seconds, 10 seconds, 15 seconds, just wandering around. Come on, wake up. You have a feast to join. This is a huge heart. Okay. All powers flows from the heart. Yeah, let's eat the great heart. It was delicious. So many hearts over here. Come on, let's clear the table. Let's not make a mess. Oh man, this game is so weird sometimes. Okay, so you just got a level up. And let's put that shovel over there. Now it's morning. For goblin hearts. But I want to eat them, not give them away. The only thing I find hard is that sometimes you will lose your way and, you know, the map doesn't really help that much. So right now we are in Berry's field and I need to get back to the shipwreck. This the right way? I think it's the right way. Hey, this is the old lady that helped us. Aha! Okay, that didn't open. So remember your quest, because nothing will show you what to do in the game. It's just a lot of exploration and a lot of fun. Again, I'm just fascinated by the game, so that's why I didn't, you know, make such a huge commentary. Just playing the game and enjoying it. Okay, we're back on the beach. Oh, that's our old bed. That's the flag. So let's see what we can do here. Nothing there. A forbidden key. Easy now, easy. And yeah, grave digging is my favorite occupation in some of the games. Nothing? Ah, just a skeleton. Who cares about the skeletons? So yeah, that was the fun part of the game. Mr. Cheese Guy is always here. Nothing over there to unearth. No secrets, no nothing. Now, did we get an elixir or something? Yeah, so that was basically what we spent. Be careful, they're very expensive, so yeah, remember. So that's a graveyard over there, and there is another smaller graveyard over here. Let's can see, nothing is really told to you. You have to figure things out. A piece of ham, delicious. Ah, maybe he wanted a snack. If you like this kind of game where nothing is explained and you have to figure things out for yourself, and you know, sometimes you'll have a hard time. The game is pretty stable, but you know, it will have some occasional problems here and there. So don't forget to sleep often, to save again the game, that is. Not actually sure how much I'll play this. I think I'll play it for, I don't know, maybe 2 or 3 or 4 episodes, because this is pretty fun. And you know, it's unique, and that's what I like about the game. It has to be a little unique, a little fun, you know. Sorry guys, someone will come and clean up this mess, I promise, but it won't be me. Also, I'm out of stamina, so I'll just have to walk for a little bit. And this door is of course opened. So we can explore a bit in this part of the map and see what we find. So I could have picked up that shovel and not buy one from the merchant. Yes. Maybe it will break, who knows. So yeah, don't buy that shovel. You can get one for free in here. Excuse me? Why am I here in the zombie convention? Yeah, so this is basically the combat. By the way, if you hold the mouse, it will actually bring up your shield. Sorry guys, I didn't know you're busy here. Okay, last one. By the way, he's destroying our armor. And he sure ran away. And hitting will consume your stamina. Come here. One more time. Yeah. Zombies. You never get... They look like plastiline zombies. You can never get rid of them, right? And this is a good time to end the game. I'll see you next time. Bye!